So good evening, everyone. Today we are going to, good evening, everyone. We are very excited to welcome Dr. Ramesh Japra, one of the most successful Indian Americans in the Bay Area. And he has been instrumental in not just being a big help to the Indian community, but as well as creating some of the first in the Bay Area, including the Hindu Temple and the Festival of Globe. And he's a very well-known heart surgeon and was the chief of staff at the Washington Medical Center in Fremont. And apart from that, he also helps a lot of nonprofits and a lot of people in his local community, as well as throughout the US and in India as well. And what we are going to do is, we are going to have half of the interview in English and half in Hindi. And if you want to hear the rest of the Hindi version also in English, then please switch on your subtitles and you will be able to understand what we are talking about. So without much further ado, I would like to welcome Dr. Japra and have him also add to the introduction on how he, on how he came to the Bay Area and how he got so successful and things like that. And I will keep on asking him questions as we go along the way. So Dr. Japra, thank you so much for making the time to join us on the first episode of Indian American TV. And I'm so excited to have you here. And I couldn't have picked a better person to start the Indian American TV bilingual channel. So
thank you. Thank you, Anita. First of all, congratulations on your Indian American TV, this inauguration and the first show. I tell you, you'll do a wonderful job. We are very, very proud of you, what you've been able to accomplish in the past. And I've worked with you, and I'm sure 100% that this is going to be very, very successful. It's going to be very, very informative to all your audiences and your viewers out there who are watching it. And it's going to be a lot of fun, a lot of information, a lot of knowledge, and a lot of excitement. I think that's what life is all about. And thank you for your generous introduction. I've been a karma yogi, as you know, I love to do karmas and dharma and karma theory, which belongs to the Hinduism, which we'll probably talk about a little bit later on. I have been practically doing it. A lot of people talk about it. Uh-huh. It's been written in Upanishads and in Gita and everywhere else. But I think practically I've been able to utilize it to the fullest. And that has been the main reason why I always feel happy, content, and been able to help a lot of people other than myself, my family, and the friends.
Well, thank you so much. That's quite a few words of wisdom. And as we have all seen, really, you live the karma and you live the dharma. And that's one of the reasons we are so impressed and so look up to you and get inspired by you on what it is that we can achieve. Sky is the limit, or maybe not even the sky, if we learn from you. So I would like to ask you some of the things about your immigration to the US. So what are some of the challenges you faced when you came? Because right now we have lots of Indians, but when you came, I think there were very few. So you might have had more struggles than people like me or the people who come after me will have. So I would love to know your words of wisdom and learn from it, so that the US can also learn from it.
Absolutely, Anita. I never call them struggles. I always call them challenges, and you take them as challenges. There's nothing like failures or struggles in life. I think you gotta take it everything as a challenge, and learn from everything. Even if you don't expect what you expected, you don't get it. I think you learn a lot from every experience what you have in life, and as long as you don't get discouraged, don't get disappointed, and continue with your mission, with your goals, what objectives you have in life, what you want to achieve, what you want to do, there's nothing wrong with it. Sometimes you succeed, sometimes it goes a different ways, but every time you learn a lot. And in our Hindu theory, we believe in that. Sometimes it's good that that thing happened, because otherwise maybe you would have gone different ways, or you've been able to too content and never been able to continue with your path which you have chosen, which you've been able to accomplish in the end. So I never look back and say that something went wrong or something I did wrong. A lot of challenges when you first come as an immigrant, like every immigrant, you know, America is a land of immigrants, but at the same time, it's a land of opportunities. So that's one of the reasons immigrants come to this country from all over the world. I mean, this is the place which originally became, you know, the people who really were brave, who were champions, who were risk takers, who did not care about, you know, their lives, even made a lot of sacrifices, a lot of unknown stuff. And that's the beauty of this land of opportunities, great United States of America. And when we come here, you know, nothing comes on a platter plate, you know, the platter of gold or whatever people think it's gonna happen. We have to make our way up, and that's a beauty. And if you get everything, you know, on the platter, you will never enjoy it. It'll be a temporary, very transient, very ephemeral, you know, satisfaction. But if you like what you call struggle, and I call the challenges, you go through these lives, ups and downs, and then you achieve something, you're gonna really feel good about it, and it's gonna be a lot more permanence to it. So in the beginning, you know, like you said, we look different, we look, you know, brown, we're not white, we're not black, and you know, we're somewhere in between. But the good part we had was the education, the knowledge, and the willingness to, you know, really take everything with a stride and work hard. And with a little bit of luck, I think many of us have been able to be very, very successful, especially here in the Silicon Valley, in San Francisco Bay Area. I think the opportunities have been really unbelievable, unprecedented. And that's one of the reasons we've been able to be very, very successful.
Thank you, Dr. Japra. And I really like that you mentioned that if we get something very easily, we don't appreciate it that much. But if we have to work hard, we tend to appreciate it more, and we like to keep it much more cherished way. And also when we know that if we work hard enough, we will achieve our goals. So that's a very good message for our audience, especially in the times of COVID, when so many people are going through so many stuff in their lives, and some people are finding it tough to not get depressed and tough to get on with their life with the new change circumstances. So thank you, I appreciate that. And my next question to you is, tell us a little bit about your background in India, and why did you decide to come to the US and not practice in India?
Well, you know, good or bad, you know, I come from a very modest family back home from Punjab, which is North India. Mm-hmm. Grew up in a village where there were only 400 people. Did my, wow, you know, middle school, went to high school in the town, which was a little bigger than that. And then, you know, came to New Delhi, where I, All India Institute of Medical Sciences, did my MD degree. And those days, you know, the opportunities in India as a physician, unless you just want to do in the civil doctor, there were not that many. And if you want to have to do a private practice, you needed a lot of money. Otherwise, you could probably just do a job. And especially if you wanted to learn a lot more about advanced medicine, the opportunities were not there. Yeah. In those days, I'm talking about 60s and 70s. And so I had, you know, went to medical school in 67 and got out 72 and came here in 73. So to do some further residency fellowship, which I went to New York and then went to Cleveland Clinic. Mm-hmm. And there I was able to get a lot more knowledge about medicine, about advanced cardiology. I always wanted to be a cardiologist because there's a lot more excitement. So I had always, you know, right from medical school itself, and I've been fortunate that I was able to do it. So that was the main reason to, and then many of us thought that we're gonna go back after we get higher education here, but like anybody else here, then you can't utilize many of these things which we learn here. And here with the land of opportunities, the land of the freedom, what you get here, liberty you get here, absolutely so enticing. And, you know, the world has become so small. It's a globalization these days. So anywhere in the world, wherever you can excel, wherever you can avail of the opportunities, one should probably stay there and continue to grow and prosper.
I totally agree. Like, wherever you find the amicable environment where you can put the roots down. But my question to you is, because you came such a long time back, maybe before I was born, but so were there many Indian students in your class when you came for your further studies for your medical practice, or were you the only one?
No, there were a few other Indian Americans, but, you know, of course, the people from all over the world are here, from South America, from Europe, from Africa, so everybody, so which is actually a great way to learn the whole world. You know, when you have your colleagues who are from different countries in the world, and you interact with them, you learn a lot. And same thing even in New Delhi in India. You know, as you know, India is almost, you know, so many states, 25 states out there. And there were people from all over the country, from north, east, west, south, and we have so many languages, and we have to interact with them, and you learn a lot. So the more diverse and more variety of people you meet, the more you learn.
No, that's so totally true. They always say that have friends who are totally opposite to you or totally different age group, because then you learn more than if you have a similar people just around you, right? So what made you come to California? Because you mentioned Ohio and you mentioned New York in your studies. So what made you move to California, the sunny state?
Sure. You know, when I was in New York, Mount Sinai Hospital, you know, of course, during the residency, you hardly get any other time to do anything else. 7/24, sometimes 3-4 days in a row, we are working. Same thing in Cleveland, where, you know, the weather, of course, almost 9 months in a year, it's going to be snowing or the weather's going to be bad. You don't see the sun more than 2 to 3 months. Mm-hmm. And we had visited California during that period, just on my vacation. And I just fell in love with California at that time. We drove all the way from north to south. And then it was just so beautiful right across the coast. And I said, after I finished my fellowship and residency, I'm going to definitely move here and start working in California. That's exactly what I did.
Well, that's amazing, because you have created so many things for the Californians and your local community that everyone is lucky to have you. And I'm glad that you decided to move to California. And also, I heard somewhere, or even saw in the movies, that you were the first one to open a Hindu temple in the Bay Area or in the California. So how difficult was it to open that when people were not aware, and what made you decide to do that and stick with it?
Sure. You know, I mean, I was a practicing cardiologist here, and there were a few, like you said, there were not too many Indian Americans those days, and a few of the Hindu Americans who wanted to do the prayers and then worshiping, and they had to go to the churches, you know, only on over the weekend. And even there, the Sundays, they had their own service, so they had a hard time. Sometimes they had to move it to Saturday or different timings. And it was very difficult to get a permit to those days because of, you know, these Hare Rama, Hare Krishna people, the ISKCON people, you know, those days, the local people thought we are here to convert them. Uh-huh. And so they were getting scared. And some of the hippies from here were going to India, back in the Himalayas, you know, and they thought those people, we are the ones who are encouraging them or enticing them. So mm-hmm. it was very difficult to get a place to worship. Fortunately, you know, the mayor was my patient. So I asked him, he tried a few places to get us a permit. He was not successful. Luckily, you know, there was a church, Seventh-day Adventist Church. So they were looking for a bigger church. So the mayor told me that, why didn't you get this church? You don't need a permit after that. Mm-hmm. So we bought it for $400,000. I collected $80,000 down payment. Mm-hmm. Then they won't give us a loan. But 10 of us put you know, our houses on collaterals and got the loan. So we got this church and then converted into a temple. But that was an easy way. Even though we had some challenges, you know, some of the local people, some of the kids still were throwing eggs you know, at the temple and at the signs of Om. But we were able to talk to them, go to their homes, and you know, really negotiate. And they all were very, very helpful after that. And especially, like I said, the mayor and some of the politicians, when we tried to make friends with them. And then as a community, we said, we are the most peaceful, we're the professionals, yeah. And we are not here to convert anybody. As a matter of fact, we started inviting them on Thanksgiving, have dinners together, have the toy drive, have the blankets drives, and all kind of things, worked with the mainstream Americans. And they then became part of that. And after that, you know, of course, we started doing our festivals and parades and everything else, so that we could showcase not only just our religion, but our culture, our civilization, our philosophy, and our narrative, which is a lot more than just the religion. As you know, the Hinduism is not a religion, it's just way beyond just a religion. And that's what we are so proud of, and that's what we've been able to showcase and share with everybody else.
Oh, that's really amazing. Like, talk about perseverance, right? Some people tend to give up after the first obstacle, and here you had to face so much. But right now, I've been to the temple so many times. It's a beautiful, and lots of other people also come, some just to see, some for the food and for other cultural activities. So thank you so much for doing it for all of us and showing us that doesn't matter how many, I would say, challenges come in between. I won't call it obstacles because you don't like to call them obstacles. So, but still, if you persevere, then in the end, you will be successful and you will have it even bigger than your dreams. Because right now, I think that's the most popular temple in the Bay Area, where everyone likes to go and everyone likes to visit. And it's beautiful and it's still like making differences in so many people's lives. So thanks a lot for that. And my next question will be in Hindi. So I would say, like, जब आप ये सब कर रहे थे और आप टेम्पल बना रहे थे, अपना प्रैक्टिस एस्टेब्लिश कर रहे थे, तो क्या क्या और अड़चन आए बीच में आपके लाइफ में, जिसके कारण आपको ज्यादा समय लगा, या कभी आपको लगा रहे मैं शायद नहीं कर पाऊंगा, ऐसा कुछ हुआ क्या?
हाँ, बहुत कुछ हुआ ऐसा क्योंकि हम उसके बाद हमारे जो बच्चे थे यहाँ पर, हाँ. वो काफी उनके साथ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन होता था. जब कॉलेज स्कूल्स में जाते थे तो वहाँ लिख देते कि आप वापस चले जाओ, आप यहाँ पे ये नहीं कर सकते. तो क्योंकि उनकी ड्रेसेस कई बार अलग अलग होती थी, उनका बोलने का अलग और एक्सेंट अलग होता था, तो हमने फिर उनके लिए पहले तो सारी क्लासेस शुरू की यहाँ पर मंदिर में, इसलिए हम हिंदू टेंपल एंड कल्चरल सेंटर बोलते हैं इसको. और उसके बाद हम यहाँ पर ये सेमिनार्स और कॉन्फ्रेंसेज वगैरह भी करते थे. और ये 3-4 साल में यूनिटी कॉन्फ्रेंसेज की, तो ऑलमोस्ट 2-3 हज़ार लोग इकट्ठे हो जाते थे. तो एक उसके बाद एक ऐसा इंसिडेंट हुआ कि हम अंदर कर रहे थे और बाहर एक बार थोड़े से खालिस्तानी, जो कि हमारे पंजाब से खालिस्तानी उन दिनों में काफ़ी उनमें जोश था, तो वो बाहर प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे थे. तो सैन होसे मर्करी ने उनकी एक बहुत बड़ी पिक्चर लगाकर फ्रंट पेज के ऊपर लिख दिया है वहाँ पर कि पुअर सिख्स you know, protesting for a homeland while rich Hindus were feasting inside Fairmont Hotel. And we were so shocked about us, what we were doing and what we were not doing. So hum jaakar mile fir inko publisher ko San Jose Mercury ke, usko bola ke ye kya aapne ye 10-12 logon ki picture laga di aur jo 2000 log andar seminar kar rahe the bachchon ke sath, you know, we were between parents and children, how to grow up in two cultures, whether to have sex before marriage, whether to have you know, dating and all these kind of things, jo ke un dino mein bachche karte the, to hum unke upar discussion karte the ki kaise unko sikhaya jaye. Aur kyunki kai log purane khayalon ke jo hamare log hote the unko rokte the, unko band karte the, aur wahan par bachche uska virodh karte the. तो वो कहता है कि ये चीजें सब ठीक हैं, ये न्यूज लेटर के लिए अच्छी हैं, हमारे न्यूज़पेपर के लिए नहीं, हमें कुछ धमाकेदार चीज चाहिए, जो कि जैसे ये प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हैं, आप तो अंदर बैठे हुए हैं ये बातें कर रहे हैं, उससे हमें कोई मतलब नहीं है, तो हम उसके बारे में कुछ नहीं लिखेंगे. तो मैंने कहा, फिर उसकी बात ठीक थी, वो कहता कि हमें सेंसेशनल न्यूज चाहिए जिससे कि हमारा पेपर न्यूज़पेपर बिके और लोग पढ़ने वाले पढ़े उसको. तो हम उठ के बाद जा रहे थे तो उसके पास मैं वापस गया, मैंने कहा इफ यू वर मी तो व्हाट वुड यू डू. आई नो हिज नेम जॉन स्मिथ. तो कहता कि यू नो इफ आई वर यू आई विल गेट आउट एंड डू द सेम फंक्शंस आउटसाइड एंड रादर देन डूइंग इट इनसाइड सो दैट पीपल कैन वॉच एंड पार्टिसिपेट. So that was the reason in 93 then I started doing a India Day parade and festival. We called it Festival of India those days, which later on became Festival of Globe. So humne bahar shuru kar diya parade. Pehle saal 5000 log aaye, uske baad karte karte abhi almost 1 lakh 1.5 lakh ke kareeb log ho jate hain, about 150,000 people sometimes in the parade. And we have 6 lanes closed on Pasio Padre in Fremont for the parade. We have a 2-day mela. So now we showcase our culture. Thousands of kids participate in cultural program, whether they're dances, singing, folk dances, cultural dances, classical, semi-classical. So all kind of activities happens. And then we share our food, you know, different food and different clothes, different jewelry, different fashions with everybody else. So it's been a lot of fun, a lot of excitement, a lot of sharing of our culture with the mainstream people. And many other cultures come join us now, Chinese American, Russians American, Hispanics, African Americans, they all come and join us now in a festival. So it's been a great journey from that point of view. But in the beginning, you know, when I lost $70,000 in the very first parade, people thought we're going to have to close it. I had to write that check myself. But fortunately, now the things have been good. We got a lot of sponsors. तो काफी लोग मिल जाते हैं और लोग भी पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं बहुत ही एंथुसियाज्म के साथ. लोग इसमें पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं, पॉलिटिशियन जो हैं हमारे सभी उसमें आना चाहते हैं. ऑलमोस्ट 30-40 लोग पॉलिटिशियन उसमें पार्टिसिपेट करते हैं. तो हमारे लोगों के लिए रोल मॉडल भी बन जाता है कि जो बच्चे हैं उनके लिए रोल मॉडल के ये देखिए इतने बड़े बड़े लोग बन सकते हैं हमारे रोल मॉडल. तो CEOs, नॉट ओनली द CEOs ऑफ द सिलिकॉन वैली companies of you know Google, Adobe and Microsoft and all these, but also in politics many of our Indian Americans have become congressmen and senators and you know local assemblymen, mayors and everybody else. So they all participate. So it's a you know a lot of kids are getting a lot of excitement, you know, their role models, and then they try to emulate. And they try to get a lot more ambitious, work harder, and we try to mentor them sometimes, you know, how to do it and how to go about it. So, इससे काफी लोगों को फायदा हुआ है, बच्चों को फायदा हुआ है, हमारी community को फायदा हुआ है, empowerment होती है, culturally, economically, socially, और उसके बाद अभी हमने एक political wing भी शुरू किया है, जिसके बारे में फिर बात करेंगे आपसे.
नहीं बहुत इम्प्रेसिव है कि आपने वो जो एक प्रॉब्लम आई डिस्क्रिमिनेशन की या कल्चरल डिफरेंस की उससे भागने के बजाय आपने या फिर छुपने के बजाय आपने उसका सॉल्यूशन तैयार किया राइट कि हम ये करेंगे ये फेस्टिवल करेंगे या फिर इवन जो आपको अपॉर्चुनिटी मिला कि उसने बोला अरे बाहर करेंगे तो हम ज्यादा लोग देखेंगे तो फिर आपने उसको ले करके किया और अपने भी मतलब पैसे लगाए और बाकियों को भी इतना इम्प्रेस किया कि वो भी पार्टिसिपेट करें और अब तो काफी बड़ा हो चुका है ये फेस्टिवल और काफी लोग सारे लोग फॉक का नाम जानते हैं और आपका नाम जानते हैं बे एरिया में और जितने लोग इंडियन अमेरिकन हैं उनको काफी अच्छा लगता है ये जान करके कि आप इतना कुछ कर रहे हैं अपनी कम्युनिटी के लिए और उनको भी इंस्पिरेशन मिलता है कि वो भी कुछ और करें और सच में आपने बहुत अच्छा अपना स्टेटस बनाया है कि सारे सिर्फ CEOs ही नहीं कि सारे पॉलिटिशियंस और ये लोग भी आते हैं और ये लोग भी सीखते हैं कि हाँ इतने सफल हो सकते हैं बाकी लोग भी राइट जो यंगर जनरेशन है. तो आप अपनी उपलब्धियों के बारे में दर्शकों को बताते हुए ये बताइए कि कौन सी उपलब्धि आपको सबसे ज्यादा प्रिय है इन सबों में.
देखिए प्रिय तो यू नो जैसे जैसे हमारा होता है कि हमारे तो गीता में लिखा हुआ है कि यू नो कर्म करते जाइए और फल की परवाह नहीं करिए. फल तो मिलेंगे बाद में मिले इस जन्म में मिले अगले जन्म में मिले कभी भी मिले कोई ऐसी बात नहीं है. क्योंकि जो हम काम करते हैं जो सिर्फ अवार्ड लेने के लिए या अपने आप को ऊंचा करने के लिए नहीं करते we have to feel good about it. आप उसके बारे में पूरी पैशन के साथ लगन के साथ इसमें काम करना चाहिए और जब तक आप लगन के साथ काम करोगे आपको अंदरूनी खुशी बहुत मिलती है और उसमें आपको फिर ये परवानी होती है कि आपकी ये सफलता कितनी ऊंची हुई है कम हुई है आप जिस चीज में भी बिलीव करते हैं और उसको पा लेते हैं तो बहुत ही अंदरूनी खुशी होती है तो इसलिए अभी तक मुझे कोई ऐसा नहीं लगा कि यू नो हमने कोई ऐसा काम किया हो फॉर्चुनेटली सबसे मिलके और अच्छी इंटेंशंस के साथ किया है तो उसमें हमेशा सफलता मिली है और उसके साथ साथ खुशी मिली है
ये तो बहुत अच्छा बहुत ही विजडम वाली बात कही आपने कि ये सिर्फ सफलता के लिए नहीं उससे अंदरूनी जो खुशी मिलती है वो ज्यादा इम्पोर्टेंट है और वो सही भी है तब आदमी को ज्यादा अगर मन से शांति है तो बाहर की कुछ भी हो उससे फर्क नहीं पड़ता उतना ज्यादा अंदर में तो जो भारतीय भारत से यूएस आना चाहता हो या यूके या वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड में कहीं जाना चाहता हो उसके लिए आप क्या संदेश देना चाहेंगे
देखिए जो जो आते हैं शुरू में लोग मोस्टली इकॉनमी इकोनॉमिक रीजन होता है सबका कि शायद हम वहां पर जाकर अच्छा काम मिलेगा अच्छे पैसे बनाएंगे अच्छी लाइफ जी पाएंगे तो ये सबका मकसद होता है जैसे कि कहीं भी से हो कोई इंडिया से हो या मैक्सिको से हो या कहीं अफ्रीका से हो या यूरोप से हो सभी इसीलिए आते हैं पहली बार तो मेरा कहने का मतलब आजकल ग्लोब में काफ़ी अपॉर्चुनिटीज मिलनी शुरू हो गई हैं इंडिया में भी बहुत सी अपॉर्चुनिटीज मिल रही हैं क्योंकि हम सब लोग जो काम यहाँ पे अमेरिकन्स ने सिखाया है जो फ्रीडम लिबर्टी पीस एंड यू नो प्रॉस्पेरिटी उसका हर कोने में उसका मकसद बन रहा है अनफॉर्चुनेटली देर आर सम कंट्रीज जहाँ पर अभी भी डिक्टेटरशिप चलती है कम्युनिज्म मार्क्सिज्म इस्लामिज्म यू नो ऐसी चीज़ें अभी भी डिक्टेट कर रही हैं तो वो कंट्रीज होपफुली डाउन द लाइन विल चेंज एंड पीपल विल लर्न व्हाट डेमोक्रेसी इज ऑल अबाउट कि हमें व्हाट वी एंजॉय फ्रॉम इनसाइड बीइंग फ्री पीपल व्हेन यू हैव फ्रीडम ऑफ स्पीच यू कैन बाय थिंग्स एनी टाइम एनीवेयर इफ यू डोंट वांट टू बाय यू वांट टू बी जस्ट एन आर्टिस्ट यू वांट टू बी जस्ट अ रीडर और जस्ट बी author or a journalist or singer or anything you know wherever you are you can enjoy but the beauty about America is so if you have a passion if you want to you know whether it's a profession or being an artist or something else in America the opportunities are tremendous and rewards are also tremendous the more risk you take the more rewards You're gonna get. So once you leave, मैं इमिग्रेशन वालों को यही बोलता हूँ कि कई लोग रोकते रहते हैं यार अभी वहाँ पर जॉब नहीं मिली मुझे मेरे को पता नहीं H1 में हूँ जाऊँ यहाँ मिलेगा या नहीं मिलेगा तो ऐसा नहीं सोचना चाहिए जब आपने सोचा कि मैंने जाना है और ये काम करना है तो निकल पड़ना चाहिए और आ जाना चाहिए तो अपॉर्चुनिटीज तो मिलेंगी ज़रूर मिलेंगी आप जितने लोगों से ज़्यादा मिल सकते हो उनसे मिलिए और जो लोग आपकी हेल्प कर पाते हैं जो आपको पता लगे कि कौन कौन लोग ज़्यादा हेल्प करते हैं उनके साथ जाकर मिलिए तो वो आपको बताएंगे और आपका काम और भी आसान कर देंगे कई बार तो जैसे आपने कहा कि स्ट्रगल करके सीखना पड़ता है और कई बार दूसरों के एक्सपीरियंस से सीख लें तो बहुत ज़्यादा अच्छा रहता है और वो आपको सीधे रास्ते पर डाल देते हैं तो इसलिए ये चीज़ें ध्यान में रखते हुए एक बार निकल जाओ और काम करते जाओ दिल लगाकर और फल की परवाह किए बिना आपको एब्सोल्युटली सफलता जरूर मिलेगी
ये वो तो सही बात है अगर फल से अटैचमेंट हो गया रिजल्ट से तो फिर आदमी नहीं मिला तो ज्यादा दुखी हो जाता है और अगर अटैचमेंट नहीं है तो हमेशा सफलता मिलती है कि मैंने ये काम किया और ये भी आपने बहुत सही बोला कि कोई मेंटर ढूंढ ले कहीं भी नई जगह जाए ताकि वो मिस्टेक जो मेंटर्स ने किए वो नहीं करें टोनी रॉबिन्स भी यही कहते हैं अपने सब में कि फाइंड समवन हु हैज डन इट एंड लर्न फ्रॉम देम तब जल्दी आगे बढ़ोगे कंपेयर टू कि अपने खुद से हम ट्रायल एंड एरर में अंधेरे में तीर मार के देखेंगे कहीं लगता है कि नहीं राइट तो एक और क्वेश्चन आपसे ये है मेरा कि जब जो भारतीय बाहर गए वो मेंटर और ये आपने बोला, उसके अलावा कल्चरली उनको क्या क्या अवेयर होना चाहिए, क्योंकि जैसे बहुत इवन इंडिया में भी कुछ अगर बिग सिटीज को छोड़ दीजिए तो यहाँ का कल्चर काफी डिफरेंट है उससे, राइट? बिग सिटी में फिर भी थोड़ा थोड़ा वेस्टर्न कल्चर जा रहा है, तो वो लोग किस चीज के लिए मेंटली तैयार रहे यहाँ आए तो?
देखिए, एक तो उसमें डर नहीं होना चाहिए. सी, द बिगेस्ट एनमी इज योर फियर. इफ यू आर टू अफ्रेड ऑफ दीज थिंग्स के पता नहीं वहां पे ये लोग एक्सेप्ट करेंगे या नहीं करेंगे, या ये होगा वो होगा, ऐसी कोई बात नहीं होती. मैं हर जगह घुमा हूँ, आई गॉन ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. ऑस्ट्रेलिया में चले जाओ, फ्रांस में चले जाओ, कहीं चले जाओ, वही चीजें होती हैं सबके लिए.
हाँ सही बात,
द सेम काइंड ऑफ पीपल, सेम थिंग्स. एंड इफ यू आर यू हैव द कॉन्फिडेंस, you know exactly what you're doing and what your talent is, and you can exhibit your talent and you can showcase your talent. I don't think those other things gonna matter that much. People will appreciate कि आपके में ये talent है, आप इसको showcase कर रहे हो. Whether आपका accent खराब है, या आपकी dress थोड़ी खराब थी, या आपका चलने का अंदाज, जब बोलने का अंदाज कुछ अलग था, तो आई डोंट थिंक दोज मैटर अ लॉट. क्योंकि इफ यू बिकम सेल्फ कॉन्शियस, आप उसी से डरते रहोगे, पता नहीं ये होगा या नहीं होगा. सो दोज थिंग्स इन द बिगिनिंग, आई रिमेम्बर लॉट ऑफ पीपल यूज टू टॉक अबाउट इट. बट दीज डेज विद द ग्लोबल कम्युनिटीज ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड, आई थिंक इट इज बिकम लेस ऑफ अ प्रॉब्लम. एज अ मैटर ऑफ फैक्ट, द पीपल हु रियली ट्राई टू फेक देमसेल्व्स और ट्राई टू बिकम, कहते हैं ना, ड्रामा करते हैं, जब प्ले करते हैं अपने आप को आर्टिफिशियलिटी में डालकर शो केस करना चाहते हैं, वो लोग ज्यादा फेल होते हैं. क्योंकि पीपल कैन सी दैट दे आर नॉट जेन्युइन पीपल, दे आर फेक पीपल. तो दैट डजंट लास्ट टू लॉन्ग. इट मे गिव ए गुड फर्स्ट इम्प्रेशन, बट पीपल विल फाइंड आउट प्रीटी सून व्हेन दे डील विद यू लिटिल बिट मोर देन दैट. सो इसलिए इतना घबराने की बात नहीं होनी चाहिए. ऑल दीज थिंग्स यू विल लर्न एज यू गो अलोंग, एंड एंड बी फियरलेस एंड आस्क पीपल, इफ दिस इज ओके टू डू दिस, द कस्टम इज डिफरेंट. इफ द कस्टम इज डिफरेंट, आई डोंट वांट टू ऑफेंड एनीबॉडी, दिस इज द वे आई डू इट. इफ समथिंग डिफरेंट, आई वुड रादर डू इट दैट वे ऑल्सो. हमारे लोग पंजाब में तो कहते थे गंगा गए गंगा राम, जमुना गए जमुना दास, तो ये सीखनी चढ़ती है. जहाँ पे भी है वहाँ का थोड़ा सा आव भाव सीखिए और उसके मुताबिक सारा काम करें, तो जिंदगी थोड़ी सी आसान हो जाती है.
नहीं, वो तो सही सही कहा आपने, और हार्ड देयर इज नो सब्स्टिट्यूट फॉर हार्ड वर्क एंड आल्सो ओपननेस टू लर्निंग, राइट? किसी को
यस,
जजमेंट नहीं दे बल्कि सीखे कि उससे क्या हम सीख सकते हैं और अपना क्या अच्छा चीज कर सकते हैं। और आपने थोड़ी देर पहले बताया था कि आपने एक और पॉलिटिकली भी अभी कोई ग्रुप स्टार्ट किया है, तो उसके बारे में आप बताएंगे थोड़ा?
जरूर. जैसे कि अभी इतने साल मैंने जहाँ पर काम किया है, 40 साल के करीब, तो उसमें मोस्टली हमने कल्चरल, सोशल, इकोनॉमिक एम्पावरमेंट के लिए, कम्युनिटीज को के लिए काम किया है. एंड वी थॉट दैट वाज द मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग. एंड द अदर थिंग वाज द इंडिया एंड यूएस रिलेशंस, विच वी बीन वर्किंग ऑल दीज ईयर्स. I've been president of the Indo-American Forum for Political Education at the national level, at the National Federation of Indo-Americans, and with the API, the physician associations, even these hotel motel association, through my newspaper, India Post, I used to go there and attend those conferences and conventions with them. So national level. So those, that empowerment is important for all the professionals, for cultural organizations, and like I said, socially also. But what we have realized that unless the communities can participate politically also and get the political empowerment, I tell you, it's always something is lacking. And we have seen it in many, many countries, in Uganda and Indonesia, Fiji Islands, even some of the other countries wherever Indians have done very well business-wise, economically. I think they have failed politically, and eventually they were thrown out in many places. And so we don't want that happen to our immigrant communities. Fortunately, America is different, but you never know unless you participate, you know, it happened to Japanese over here in America as well. And yeah. One time they were thrown into jails and internments right here when there was a war, you know, Second World War. Mm-hmm. So I think those things can happen. So that's why the political participation and empowerment engagement is important. So we started something called Americans for Hindus. Yeah. And, you know, especially the political field here has become quite different, you know, too many extremes. The people either too much to the right or too much to the left. And hamari jo Hindu philosophy hai, we are basically, we are not to the left, not to the right, but centrist. Yeah. And I think that, in my opinion, is the best way. And with the Hindu philosophy, you know, not as a religion, but as a Hindu philosophy and our ideology, we, you know, we believe in that, we have mutual respect for all the religions. We are always, you know, we love freedom, we love nonviolence, we love peace, truthfulness, righteousness, all these great things, which, you know, great constitutions have written, United States or India or UK or all these constitutions, believe in those. I think our philosophy for thousands of years, more than 5,000 years, have been believing in it. And if we try to promote that, Vasudeva Kutumbakam, the whole world is a family, and also Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu, that we want prosperity for everyone.
Yeah.
Out there, doesn't matter. But if people are dharmis, those who really want to take America or any other country to the extremes, like now the leftist people try to make them socialist, Marxist, ultra leftist. So that way, you know, the whole infrastructure will fall apart. It'll get dismantled, because why we came here for an American dream, like you said earlier. If you have the opportunity, anybody, whether you're a taxi driver or you're a doctor or an IT person or an artist, you can become a millionaire here.
Yeah,
that's the beauty, and that's American dream, which everybody should get it. Some people get it, some people may not, but they should all try and they should work hard for it. But if you get into socialism or Marxism, where you giving disincentive to the working people and only distributing money, I think that can only go so far, and then you're going to end up having like Venezuela and many other countries, socialist countries. And it has never been successful. So that's why we started having this thing, so that we're going to be centrist. And similarly, people who are too much to the right, who could be, you know, not believing in diversity and become racist or anything like that sort, I think we want to make sure that those people also come back to the centers as centrist, and they should work with everybody without any color, creed, sex, gender, or, you know, all these reasons, national origin, so that there should not be any kind of discrimination from that point of view. So that, with that philosophy, we have made this thing, and we've been very, very successful. A lot of Indian organizations are working with us. We've been able to get almost 20 trustees from across the country, from Florida, Texas, New York, California, Illinois. So they are all over, and then more than other 500 members and activists who are part of it. We are working hard. We are also endorsing as a super PAC many of the candidates, and six of those candidates won during this election in November. So we are very fortunate that we're going to be working with them with this ideology, and try to educate many of these congressmen, senators, even presidents, vice presidents, so that they can understand, you know, where we're coming from. So our ideology, it should be utilized by everybody, not only just for Indian Americans or Hindu Americans. So not only even America, it can go all over the world. Even back home in India, we have a lot of problems with the current government, and there's a lot of opposition to that kind of ideology. And there also the centrist philosophy works. You know, secularism and everything is fine, but at the same time, the ideology and narrative should be always respected, which Hinduism has, and it can be shared by everybody, not just Hindus, but every other religion as well. And we don't want to have these other forces, like red forces, the communism, and the green forces, the radical Islamists, come and take over these countries like India, France, and United States. We want to make sure with our ideology and philosophy, we can defeat them and counter them so that the whole world can be, a one place where they can all live with peace, nonviolence, liberty, freedom, truthfulness, and our children down the line can continue prospering and have these dream, American dream, which we've been able to achieve, some of us have been able to accomplish, and they should have those opportunities to be continued.
No, I totally agree that having a common centrist philosophy is very important in order for people to feel as one rather than divided. Like we have seen that recently in the past few months, like some people are on the totally left, some people are on the totally right, and they are always, I would say, ready to kill each other.
That's right.
I'm very impressed that you are trying to make this philosophy of like pretty much having a peaceful relationship with everyone and hearing everyone's ideology and then taking into account the liberty and the freedom of everyone before making any decision or before like being more tolerant towards others, with some of the others, as you mentioned, haven't been that far. And also I totally agree with the philosophy that there is abundance and prosperity of all. And many people here, even though they might practice it as spirituality, but I have come across some people who still follow it, and because of the spiritual aspects of it, and without realizing, okay, it's the core part of the Hindu lifestyle, I would say, not just the religion. So I'm so impressed with of the success with anything in endeavor you take. So what is your next endeavor going to be, where already I can imagine if you try it, it's going to be successful?
No, I think this journey which we have taken to give a political voice to our community, I think that's going to take a long time. This is just the beginning. We just started about a year ago, and this November election was the first one. And we want to continue not only in America, but also in back home in India and many other countries. I think our British Hindus have done very well in the last year election. And then, of course, we have few posts even in the cabinet in British, both Priya and Puneet Sanan. So they've been able to get these cabinet positions, and they're doing very, very well. And they're also, everybody was busy making money, getting businesses, until these other forces came, some of these radical Islamist forces and Khalistani forces and communist forces. And they started putting everybody else down, even Hindus down. They started calling us racist as such and among ourselves, and fascists and all these kind of things. And that's why we thought that it's important that we educate everybody what who we are and what our philosophy is. We are not here the fascists and racists, and that's what they try to do with some of these rightist white people. Here they try to do, and they want to put us in the same basket. That is totally wrong, and we want to make sure that we build our own identity and educate them, and so that whatever their ulterior motives are, so that we can defeat those motives. They have different motives, like communists have this economic-based colonialism, and some of these ISIS people have this faith-based colonialism. That's what they've been able to do all over the world, and we don't want them to succeed in America or in India, for sure, and even in Europe. I think we'll definitely try to come up with this narrative so people can get educated and unite together, whether they're Hindus or Jews or Christians or any other religion, doesn't matter, Buddhists, Sikhs, they should all unite together. And with this narrative, I think they can defeat these evil forces.
No, I totally agree that unity is important, as well as education, because people who don't know, they don't know. So they can pretty much believe anything you say. So I'm very impressed that so far what we have covered is not only you can come here and be successful in your personal, like economics, basically, like get a successful career and get economically well, but also if you, someone so is inclined, they can also enter the political arena and influence the decision making so that they are not in the trouble like the Japanese people you were mentioning during the World War II, so that we have a say in, which is also takes into account how the immigrants who are from other places feel, and their rights and liberty should not be violated as well. So what are some of the closing remarks you would share, like to share with the audience, especially the immigrant audience?
Absolutely, Nita. I think, like I said earlier, you come as an immigrant. This is a land of immigrants. You should have full confidence. You are not a foreigner here. You are part of this country. You know, once you land up on this country, there is, we call it Matribhumi and Pitribhumi, or sometime, you know, Devaki and Yashoda, and, you know, somebody else got the born and we brought up here. And so we should own this, take the ownership of this land and feel that we are part of America. We are Americans. That's what we said, for Americans. For whatever philosophy and ideology we believe in, and we should work with that. Of course, like you said, fiscally, to become successful, whether it's your profession, whether it's your passion, whatever makes you, you can be successful. If you work hard, there are a lot of opportunities. Make sure you get mentors, meet the right people. A lot of us are out there, and that's why these festivals and other places, you will meet a lot of these role models and good people. So you should meet up with those people. So that's my message. And then continue the journey, and never be satisfied, you know, with what you achieve. The whole life is a journey. I never have a mission goal. As long as you're healthy, you're able to work, and you're able to continue to march ahead. I think you're going to be enjoying your life. And that's what I do. Doesn't matter, 40 years, and I wish another 40 years I can do the same thing again and again, and well, hopefully even better.
That's so impressive, Dr. Japra. And I love the energy and the passion and the enthusiasm. And I'm very sure that the viewers and all the immigrants, they can get so inspired that there's no limit to whatever they can achieve, as long as they follow the right steps, are willing to work hard, get the right mentors, and build a community around them, or just join a community which will help them make much more successful. So thank you so much for your time, and we look forward to talking with you again. And till then, namaste.
Namaste, all the viewers. Thank you. And once again, congratulations on this initiative.
Thank you.